Hello friends, this video on Equilibrium Part 14 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Before watching the video, please make sure that you have watched all the previous parts. Let's understand the steps which we'll use to find the equilibrium concentration. We told that the Kc value is used to find the equilibrium concentration. In fact, we have solved a couple of examples also. Let's formalize this and understand the steps we use to find the equilibrium concentration. The first thing you do is you write the balanced equation. Balanced equation for the reaction is a must. Once we have the balanced equation, then we have to make a table with initial concentration, the change in concentration, and the equilibrium concentration. So we have to create these things in the table. We'll do one example to explain this. And we'll assume, for example, initial concentration was 5, let's suppose, for something. We'll assume the change in concentration is x, the equilibrium concentration will become 5 minus x. Let's assume, and we'll take some example to clear this concept. And then we have this value, and then we'll get a quadratic equation. We'll solve it to get the value of x. Once we have the value of x, we can find the equilibrium concentration of all the reactants and products. We'll take one example now. So 13.8 gram of N2O4 was placed in 1 liter reaction vessel at 400 Kelvin and allowed to attain equilibrium. The reaction is N2O4 is in equilibrium with 2NO2. All are gas. The total equilibrium pressure was found to be 9.15 bar. We have to find Kc and Kp. Since pressure is given in bar and also to find Kp, so let's find everything in the Kp terms, bar terms. So initial 1.38 T is equal to 0. 13.8 gram of N2O4 was there and 0 gram of NO2 was there. Right? And the final pressure was 9.15 bar. So one approach is to convert this bar into moles, or you can convert this moles into bar. So let's convert this gram into bar actually. How much pressure this 13.8 grams of N2O4 will create. So pressure is nothing but P is equal to nRT by V. Formula we know. What is the n number of moles? So we know that 92 grams is equal to 1 mole for N2O4, because N2O4 it is 92 if we add the atomic mass. So 92 gram of is equal to 1 mole. So 13.8 gram will be what? 13.8 by 92 moles. This is my number of moles. So let me put the value. So N will be what? 13.8 by 92. What is the value of R? 0.083, because I'm finding in bar. What is the value of T? T is given 400 Kelvin, given by V. V is 1 liter. So you solve this, you get the value is nothing but 4.98 bar. So instead of gram, I'll use T is equal to 0. The pressure was 4.98 bar, and this was 0. Right? At T is equal to equilibrium, this will become what? Let's assume that it has released X bar pressure. If it has released X bar pressure, it will create 2X bar pressure. Correct? Because X moles will create 2X moles of this. X moles of N2O4 will create 2x moles of N2O4. So total pressure at equilibrium is what? So total pressure at equilibrium is what? 4.98 minus x plus 2x, right? And that is equal to what? 9.15 bar. Correct. So you solve this. So with this, if you solve, you get x is equal to 4.17 bar. So you have the value of x, you have everything now. So pressure of N2O4 is what? N2O4 is 4.98 minus x is 4.17. That is 0.81 bar. This is the pressure of N2O4. Talk about pressure of NO2. That is about 2x. That is 2 into 4.17. That is 8.34 bar. This is my Kp and it's a partial pressure. Correct. So I got the partial pressure. I have to find Kp now. Kp is something which I didn't find now. So Kp is what? Kp will be pressure of NO2 pressure of NO2 to the power 2 by pressure of N2O4. Correct. What is the pressure of NO2? Pressure of NO2 we found was 8.34. So it will come 8.34 square by pressure of N2O4 is what? 0.81 bar. And this is bar square. So you solve this, you get 85.87 bar. That is my KP. I have the KP, I can find KC easily. Because I know the formula, KP is equal to KC RT to the power delta N. So what is KP? KP is 85.87 is equal to KC into RT, that is 0.0831 into T, that is 400. Delta N is what? This is 2 minus 1, 1. You solve this, KC out comes out to be 2.6. Since it was bar, so this becomes moles per meter. Correct? Easy only. See, since I was supposed to find partial pressure, KP, KC all, so I converted the whole this grams of N2O4 to partial pressure of N2O4. Because if you are, you can't take this part in grams, this part in partial pressure. If you are taking partial pressure as the unit here, you take partial pressure. You take everything in bar. If you want to find the concentration, you take everything in mole. So here I took everything in bar. Let's check one more question. 3 moles of PCl5 is kept in 1 liter closed reaction vessel and is allowed to reach equilibrium at 380 Kelvin. Find the composition of reaction mixture. And the KC is given 1.8. So what is the reaction? If you give PCl5 for some time, it will break into PCl3 plus Cl2. All gas. So initially, it was 3 moles of PCl5. It was 0 moles. And at T is equal to equilibrium, let's assume that X moles of PCl5 is gone. So X mole of PCl5 will create X mole of PCl3 and X mole of Cl2. All one stoichiometric coefficient. So at this point, my KC will become what? Concentration of PCl3, concentration of Cl2, and concentration of PCl5. You solve this, what do you get? So PCl, and this is equal to, or I say, KC is what? 1.8 is equal to PCl3 concentration is what? X into Cl2 is X by 3 minus X. So you solve this, you get X is equal to 1.59. You can solve this. So with this, if my X is equal to 1.59 and PCl5 is what? PCl5 will be, I have to find the composition of mixture. PCl5 is what? 3 minus X, that is 3 minus 1.59, that is 1.41 moles per liter. Concentration of PCl3 will be equal to concentration of, will be equal to concentration of Cl2, right? And both will be equal to X, that is 1.59 moles. That is my answer. Only the initial moles were given and I could easily find a concentration of PCl3 and PCl5 and Cl2 in equilibrium when its KC was given to me. Correct. One mole of H2O and one mole of CO are taken in a 10 liter vessels and heated to 725 Kelvin. At equilibrium, 40% of water by mass reacts with CO according to this equation. Calculate the equilibrium constant. So if you see at T is equal to 0, what is happening? I have 1 mole of H2O, 1 mole of CO, and there are 0 moles of hydrogen and carbon dioxide. At T is equal to equilibrium, what they are saying? So 40% of the water is used. So 40%, so if at equilibrium this becomes 1 minus X, this becomes 1 minus X, and this becomes X, and this becomes X. Normal formula we are using, right? So we are assuming that X mole is used, X mole of this will also be used because both are having same stoichiometric coefficients. In fact, all are having same stoichiometric coefficients, so reactants X moles will be used and product X moles will be created. So it is said that the X is nothing but 40% of 1 mole, because 40% of water is used and water was 1 mole. So X value we know is nothing but 0.4, correct? So let's put the value of X as 0.4. This becomes 0.6, this becomes 0.6, this becomes 0.4, this becomes 0.4. Correct. So we have to find what? The equilibrium constant. So Kc is what? Concentration of H2, concentration of CO2, divided by concentration of H2O and concentration of CO. Since all are gas, we have to include everything. So this becomes concentration of H2 is what? 0.4. CO2 is what? 0.4. This guy is 0.6. This guy is 0.6. You solve this, you get 0.44 as the answer. Easy one. And what will be the unit? There will not be any unit, because both left hand side, if you see, this becomes 0.4m, 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 0.4m. All gets cancelled. Sorry, it has to be 0.4 by 10, because 0.4 mole is there, right? See, there's a mistake I did actually, because I have to give in moles per liter. See, answer will come out to be same, but it has to be moles per liter. And there are 10 liters and it is 0.4 mole. Right, it's 0.4 moles. 0.4 mole and 0.2 mole. So it will be 0.4. I'll just redo this part. This becomes 0.4 mole by 10 liter into 0.4 mole by 10 liter, and this becomes 0.6 mole by 10 liter and 0.6 mole by 10 liter. So what you get is 0.44, and this will become m, all m, and this all m will be cancelled. So there will not be any unit for this. Correct. Thank you. Visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thanks once again.